A very good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, and a very warm welcome to each and every one of you who have gathered here to be a part of RedTeam Security Summit 2021. This session is on the topic Threat Landscape Connected Cybersecurity Training by Mr. Dimitrios Bougioukas. We are honored to have Dimitrios as a speaker at the RedTeam Security Summit 2021. Dimitrios is the Director of IT Security Training Services at the HackTheBox. Prior to joining HackTheBox, he has worked as a Business Information Security Engineer and Information Security Analyst for a major financial institution, as a penetration tester within EY's practice, and as Training Director within eLearnSecurity and INE. Dimitrios is also an informal expert at ENISA on incident response technical training and specializes in advanced cyber threat simulation, threat intelligence, and purple team tactics. He has engaged in numerous penetration testing activities against critical infrastructure, web applications, and mobile applications. We are delighted to host Mr. Dimitrios at RedTeam Security Summit 2021. So without further ado, welcome Dimitrios to the stage. The stage is all yours. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thanks everyone for the warm welcoming and the very nice summit you are hosting. Thanks also to everyone for attending my talk. Let me share my deck so that you all have visibility into what I am about to present. Okay, so thanks again everyone for attending my talk at this year's RedTeam Summit. Let me briefly introduce myself. As already mentioned, I am the Director of IT Security Services within HackTheBox. I am also working on EU cert and CISR technical trainings when it comes to topics like incident response, tactical analytics, SOC 3.0, and security orchestration, automation, and response. This function of mine is within ENISA. ENISA is the European Union's agency for cybersecurity. And again, as mentioned, my interests include cyber program management and cyber program transformation, advanced adversary simulation and black operations, tactical and strategic threat intelligence, and purple team tactics. Now, regarding today's topic, I think that we are all on the same page when saying that we have to deal with an ever-evolving threat landscape, or to be more precise, a rapidly evolving threat landscape. Deploying additional security measures is certainly not the way forward to stem the tide of cyber attacks. And as everyone is saying, currently we need to shift our attention towards cybersecurity training. That said, I think that it is about time that we dive deeper into the concept of cybersecurity training, dissect it, and come up with the building blocks of actionable, applicable, and current cybersecurity training. So in this talk, I'm going to present you with just that, the building blocks of new generation cybersecurity training. But to be honest, and as you will see further on, we will stress the fact and the importance of cybersecurity training being highly connected and constantly connected to the threat landscape. This is the cornerstone of a successful cybersecurity training program nowadays. Let's start with the basics of a cybersecurity training program. As you will see, at the foundations, at the bottom of this small Greek temple, something I designed to also honor my Greek roots, apparently, you will notice that any cybersecurity training should have these characteristics to begin with. These are minimum prerequisites, of course, guided training approach, real-world and complex lab scenarios, and continuous learning and evaluation. By continuous learning, we mean modules or chapters that are constantly up to date. And by continuous evaluation, we consider something as, you can imagine something as a skills assessment at the end of each module or at each chapter, something to solidify the student's understanding of each topic or each module. Now, there are, let's say, two aspects or two perspectives when it comes to cybersecurity training and cybersecurity in general, to be honest. The first one is what the industry and what the market needs. So, of course, cybersecurity training should be connected to the needs of the cybersecurity industry and market. This means that it should first provide the skills that are necessary to fulfill a specific IT security role or IT security function, and of course, all the tasks that come with this specific IT security role or function. But unfortunately, there is a caveat. There is the need to provide a more holistic and vendor-agnostic cybersecurity training program, but I will elaborate on that in just a bit. To move things even further, not all companies, of course, are mature enough in terms of their cybersecurity posture. In order for a cybersecurity training program to be applicable, it should also facilitate the establishment of cyber capabilities. This requires covering, of course, methodologies, processes, metrics, and also a common vocabulary, which in most cases are the established frameworks and guidelines by the likes of NIST, MITRE, PCI, central banks, and so on and so forth. What I mean by facilitating the establishment of cyber capabilities is there is no meaning in covering, for example, threat hunting in an organization that is not mature enough or that doesn't have the internal processes to accommodate threat hunting. So a training program should not only focus on the technical stuff, but also show an organization how to establish such processes, such capabilities, and then continue to the technical stuff. This is an important part that is usually missed by training vendors. Even if we offer those two pillars that we just mentioned, again, I think that we will be facing an unstructured construction. This is because, as already mentioned, there are two aspects when it comes to cybersecurity training. The first one is the one we mentioned, what the current market or the industry needs. But the other aspect is what the current threat landscape actually dictates. So I think that we will all agree and we all know that the modern cybersecurity workforce, we have to deal with a rapidly evolving threat landscape. And for them to be prepared, threat landscape connected training is also required. To provide your own clients or your own employer with more value, the modern workforce should be capable of knowing and mimicking how attackers in the wild operate. New generation cybersecurity training programs should cover and most importantly break down real attacker techniques, tactics, and procedures. And this is for those, for both penetration testers and blue team members. So we have two more building blocks. The one you see on your screen, the dissection of attacker techniques, tactics, and procedures, but also the emulation of those techniques, tactics, and procedures within a training program. Now let's dive into those four main building blocks or those four pillars, if you like. As discussed, cybersecurity training should provide the skills necessary to fulfill specific IT security roles and the technical tasks that are associated with that role. And that said, in order to provide more value to an employer or a client, a training program should follow a holistic view of things, the attacker's perspective and the defender's view as well. In order for one to be, for example, an exceptional RedTeamer, he or she should be aware of the traces that are left behind. And not only that, but he or she should be aware of the correlations that are being made based on those traces. In other words, the detection logic. Exceptional RedTeamers should also be aware of the visibility and the telemetry shortcomings blue team members face in order to stay under the radar. The same, of course, applies for blue team members. Blue team members should be able to emulate attacker techniques, tactics, and procedures in order to identify the traces left behind and start moving from indicators of compromise-based detection into detecting generic techniques. Now, I think that it should be obvious by now that knowing both sides of the coin is what will make a cybersecurity professional complete and exceptional. In addition, I think that we have all seen poor remediation and detection advice in penetration testing reports, and the approach we just mentioned, the holistic approach, will address this shortcoming of penetration testers as well. To provide maximum value, one should also not rely into automated tools, but he or she should focus on the manual approach. This is the only way to identify the underpinnings of each attacking or detection technique and be truly exceptional at what you do. For example, an attack through an automated tool may be detected for a multitude of reasons, but executing it manually can evade defensive. The same applies for an alert coming from a vendor-specific CM. It provides a layer of abstraction concealing the true detection logic, and only by knowing the underpinnings of that detection technique will make you a whole better professional. Now, moving to the building block that is related to the establishment of cyber capabilities, if one wants to get a job done in the corporate world, he or she should create specifications and, most importantly, document a business process. A cybersecurity training program should follow the same approach and should cover that as well. Then clear methodologies, metrics, and frameworks, as we mentioned, are required alongside the common vocabulary and best practices. To reiterate on what I just mentioned, and since not all organizations are mature in terms of cybersecurity, new generation cybersecurity training should help high-level individuals into defining, planning, implementing, and controlling, and finally establishing or operationalizing cyber capabilities. We need cybersecurity training to be applicable, after all. So these processes will be the basis, and then we can start moving to the technical aspects of training. But these are the basis upon which we should all be based when doing and when delivering our training. Establishing, for example, a true red teaming or threat hunting capability, as we know, is by no means a trivial task. Now, regarding the threat landscape connected training, and more specifically the tactical threat intelligence based training, it is imperative that cybersecurity professionals not only closely monitor the techniques, tactics, and procedures used by adversaries, but also dissect them to truly understand them. And not only that, but something other important to mention at this point is that when it comes to tactical threat intelligence based training, the backbone of mimicking how attackers operate is a training program that not only breaks down attacker techniques, tactics, and procedures, but also chains different techniques to showcase maximum impact. The same applies for the final building block, which is adversary simulation. New generation cybersecurity training should be heavily focused on emulating adversaries, so that it can provide students with detection points on multiple levels, and they can also provide red teamers with a very realistic approach during training. I think that by now everything will probably look a bit unstructured and without any clear action items. So I created this slide to consolidate everything and create a course of action around your cybersecurity training. So first of all, you need to make sure that all important computer science fundamentals, networking, operating systems, basic programming, everything will prove useful into your cybersecurity career, and you should focus on truly understanding these basic concepts. Then, even at the earliest stages of your career, try to be as client-centric as possible. Try to articulate and communicate your findings professionally. Practice writing commercial-grade reports, and try to provide your client or employer with in-depth attack insights and remediation advice. Of course, practice makes perfect, and you should always try to go the extra mile. Then you should, of course, focus on evolving all the skills that are necessary for the IT security role of your choice. But again, as mentioned, there is a caveat. Don't stick to the basics Always monitor the threat landscape and try to both understand and emulate techniques, tactics, and procedures that you see in the wild. The times when, for example, pivoting, tunneling, port forwarding were considered skills for intermediate penetration testers are long gone. Juniors should now possess these skills and even more if they want to provide their clients or employers with realistic engagement. So you should move the bar higher constantly. Focus, in addition, focus on executing everything manually. Don't rely on automation to get a better idea of the underpinnings of each task, of each step, of each PTP that you execute. Then, as we already mentioned, you should know both sides of the coin. When you feel that you are quite proficient in all the tasks of your role, start seeing things from the opposite perspective. If you are a red teamer, start checking the traces your attacks leave behind and the detection logic using which the blue team can detect you. The same if you are a blue teamer, focus on trying to emulate how attackers and red team members operate. Then and only then you will be able to secure more demanding and senior level cybersecurity positions, either on the red team side or the blue team side. Finally, after knowing both sides of the coin, you should focus on more business-oriented cybersecurity tasks, such as being capable of actually implementing frameworks and establishing true cyber capabilities. Then and only then you will be able to secure more manager or senior vice president level positions. And finally, be a more complete and all-around cybersecurity professional. I strongly suggest that you structure your training in such a manner. It may look a bit simplistic, but trust me, it is a very nice course of action to build your cybersecurity trade, your cybersecurity skill set, and evolve as a cybersecurity professional as the years go by. Finally, you have probably noticed that on your left side, I have also included the level of cybersecurity maturity of an organization. This is to provide you with an example that if, for example, an organization is moderately mature in terms of its cybersecurity posture, then you will probably need to reach all the way up to stage 3, for example, in order to fit into such a mature organization perfectly. This concludes my presentation, my talk. I kept it a bit short so that I can address any of your questions and have a more interactive discussion. So I am all ears, and I am waiting for any of your questions. Let me check if we have any, actually.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dimitrios. That was a wonderful session. You provided a lot of good suggestions for the audience as well. So we can now move on to the question answer session. There was already a question. Yes, now there are two questions. So you can check.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure. Let's start with the first one. How SOAR will impact the stock market, and as cyber world is moving toward more AI, World Bank is also started implementing security orchestration, automation, and response. That's a nice question, actually quite applicable to the current market. As discussed, I think that security orchestration, automation, and response will heavily impact the stock market and actually the vast majority of blue team members. But again, I need to stress the fact that all those appliances, all those solutions, all those turnkey CM solutions create a layer of abstraction and, you know, create a mist, some clouds, some fog around the actual detection logic. You should certainly be proficient in using these. They will become more and more popular, but I believe that we should all go back to the basics, try to understand what triggered this alert, what triggered this automated response action by such a solution, so that we all become more knowledgeable when it comes to what triggers those solutions, and then we can again go back and utilize them. The other thing is that if we understand what triggered each alert, we may be able to fine-tune such solutions. So feel free to use them, feel free to study them, feel free to recommend them to your organization, but always be knowledgeable and understand the underpinnings of each attack and of each detection logic. Moving to the next one, what is your point of view if a person starts his cybersecurity career from cybersecurity governance instead of starting as a red or blue team member? I think that this is actually the other way around, or from what I have suggested, but truth be told, it is quite realistic that people start from high-level positions and then continue into the more technical aspects of cybersecurity. As soon as you don't stick to the high-level aspects of cybersecurity governance, and you understand why each process should be applied, why we should focus on creating this process, why governance is required. So this is a course of action that could work. I have no objection on that. But again, try to understand why this process should be applied, why we are enforcing this policy. And then I think that you will have a successful career. So there is no right or wrong. There is no right course of action. One can start from the high level stuff, but always try to identify why we are implementing this policy, why governance is important, and so on and so forth. So there is no right course of action. As soon as you are curious, you are eager to learn why you are doing and why you are implementing something on the high level side. The third question is, could you suggest to me any source to practice black box and how? Most probably you are referring to black box penetration testing. I think that there are a lot of cybersecurity training grounds or training platforms that follow a less guided approach, the black box approach, as you mentioned. One is, of course, my current employer and company, HackTheBox, but there are others. Actually, we should mention that there are such training grounds and such training platforms that are less guided on both the red team side and the blue team side, so you can find black box training grounds on blue teaming as well that you should totally explore. Regarding the how aspect of your question, I had a clarification regarding a page. Actually, I'm only involved currently on HackTheBox, so I can't recommend anything else. I have focused my efforts on our platform. Other than that, I'm pretty sure there are other exploratory, let's say, training vendors that I can currently, I don't come up with one right now. I have an interesting question: how to switch from quality assurance to cybersecurity. Again, I think that you should follow my suggested course of action. If you are quite proficient with the computer science fundamentals, if you are not, you should, and then you should start narrowing things down and choose a role that is of interest to you. It can be the role of a penetration tester, it can be the role of a security analyst, and then you should start taking the skills that are required and start covering them and studying them one by one. If you don't want to enroll in the training of a specific IT security vendor, you can do it by yourself. It will be more time consuming, but I believe that one can do it by itself if he or she doesn't want to enroll in specific training. How HackTheBox is helpful for the blue team? Actually, I think that if you notice how attacks are implemented, you can become a better blue teamer. There are also plans to move into more blue team content, guided and exploratory blue team content for our blue team friends. But even if you start by identifying how these attacks are implemented, I think that you can go back to your organization and suggest defensives. Which is the most basic cybersecurity career for a new graduate? I think, guys, that you can either start from what I think that you can go two separate ways. One, you can go for cybersecurity and IT governance in general, so that you first learn about the high level aspects of cybersecurity and then move to the technical stuff. The most basic cybersecurity career or role on the RedTeam side should be the one of a security analyst, of a junior security analyst, or the one of a junior junior penetration tester. If we are talking about the blue team side, it should be, again, a junior security analyst. You will be tasked with analyzing some logs, you will be analyzing some CM alerts, and then you are going to escalate them if you think that something is wrong or unusual to a more experienced employee within your organization. So these should probably junior SOC, junior SOC analyst, junior penetration tester, junior security analyst. This should be the most junior level cybersecurity positions currently in the market. If you want to go to the high level side, I think that if you go for IT security governance, it will be a nice introduction into cybersecurity. As soon as you focus on the technical aspects going forward on your career to be a more complete professional. I think we have no further questions.
Yes, if you have any questions, there is a few more minutes for us, definitely. So you can ask the questions. Or audience, if you have any questions, you can post in the Q&A section, which is on the right-hand side of your screen. So do post.
Actually, guys, you can ping me on any social media. I very much enjoy staying in touch with fellow professionals. I also enjoy learning from fellow professionals. There is no master when it comes to cybersecurity, and through discussions, we can all learn. So you can hit me up in any social media, and I will be glad to connect with you, answer any questions, or even provide my insights into, you know, whatever topic. Let me check if we have any other questions.
If you can raise your hands, there is a simple, you can see that. If you raise your hands, you can come live and you can give your feedback to Mr. Dimitrios.
Oh, Actually, we have a final last question. If I can say something about Log4j, a very critical vulnerability that recently emerged. I don't want to go too into technical details regarding Log4j, but I will tell you something that I saw that was really, really surprising. You have seen multiple blog posts about Log4j. They go over the root cause of the vulnerability. They show how to remediate, how to patch it, the various payloads. But truth be told, I saw zero blog posts regarding JNDI injection, which is the technique that you use to trigger that vulnerability. This goes all the way back into what I mentioned. We should all go back to the basics, identify how this attack works. JNDI injection is quite a complex vulnerability, quite a complex technique, not a vulnerability, that you can perform and you can execute it differently based on the version of Java that you have to, let's say, play with. So I saw zero posts regarding how to actually learn about the technique that you use to trigger that vulnerability. So again, I want to stress the fact that we shouldn't focus on CVEs, we shouldn't throw exploits around, we should go all the way back to the basics, identify how we can execute these attacks, even manually, without relying on automation. And this is the only way that you will be able to understand what's going on and be truly valuable and knowledgeable. So that's my two cents, actually, when it comes to Log4j.
Once more, audience, there is a hand symbol. You can see that on the bottom right corner of your screen when you click the question answer session. If you click that, you can come live to the session and directly ask Mr. Dimitrios, or you can give your feedback. So there is that option as well. Otherwise, if you want to ask any more questions, you can post your questions. We will wait a few moments before we end the session. Mm-hmm. So I think that is the end of question answer session. Thank you so much, Mr. Dimitrios. That was a wonderful question answer session. Some really good questions, and you answered every question so beautifully. So thank you so much for your presence. Thank you so much for giving your time to us in order to take part in RedTeam Security Summit 2021. Thank you so much. I think there is one more question, so we can take that question.
HackTheBox is just a learning platform, also provides security service. Actually believe we are talking something about HackTheBox providing penetration testing services or something, which is something that we don't currently do. HackTheBox has two offerings, let's say, two big families of offerings. One is HackTheBox Academy, which is guided learning. We take you by the hand and we show you how to execute specific IT security tasks on penetration testing and on other domains. And there is the main HackTheBox platform, where you are going for a more black box and exploratory approach, where you have to hack your way in into the design boxes. But so far, no penetration testing services from our end. The final one is if we are going to offer some SCADA training on HackTheBox. This is something that is of great interest to us. We are currently exploring the difficulty when it comes to SCADA training, is how to simulate the actual labs. We don't want to offer you with a bunch of theory that you can't actually practice. By the time we find the perfect way to offer and simulate real SCADA environments so that we can implement practical labs. Be certain that we are going to release SCADA training as well.
So that is the end of the question answer session. Thank you so much. Thank you so much once again, Mr. Dimitrios. We hope to collaborate with you in the future as well. So have a great day. Have a great time ahead. Thank you so much.
Thank you.